Hi, my name is Ryan and thank you for watching this No IP support video. Today's video is designed to help prevent connection issues our users can have when trying to access their device. Here at No IP, we simply resolve a hostname or a domain to an IP address. In order to access your device, you will need to ensure your internal network is set up properly and port forwarding rules have been configured. This is a high-level walkthrough on configuring port forwarding in your router and troubleshooting some of the errors that can occur during the process. The first thing you will need to do is log into your router using the default gateway associated with the device. This can be found either on the sticker on the router itself or by using one of the two default IP addresses that are listed here. Once you are at the router login screen, you will have to log in with the default router credentials or use your own if you've logged into your router before. Once you have successfully logged into your router, you will need to find the port forwarding settings, which are usually located under Advanced. For this example, I'll be using Netgear's R7000 Nighthawk, and you can see that the port forwarding settings are located under the Advanced tabs and then the Advanced Setup dropdown. Clicking on the port forwarding settings will allow you to see all of your current port forwarding rules and configure brand new ones. As you can see, we currently do not have any port forwarding rules configured, so we will go ahead and configure brand new ones by clicking on Add Custom Service. When creating a new port forwarding rule, most routers will ask you for the same information: the service name, the protocol, the external and internal ports, and the internal IP address of the device you are trying to connect to. The service name can be whatever you want and is just used to remind you what the port forwarding rule is for. In this case, we'll just call it camera. For the protocol, you are going to want to choose both TCP and UDP to make sure that all devices can connect to your port. The internal and external port will be the number that you use to access your device and need to be the same. In this case, we'll use port 8000 to connect to our device. The last step is to add the internal IP address of the device you are trying to remotely access. The internal IP address of the device will always start with 192.168.something or 10.0.something. Most newer routers will list all the devices tied to it to make the port forwarding a little easier. In this case, we will want to access the IP camera at the top of our list. You can see that the IP address is 192.168.1.10. Once you have added all the necessary information, you will want to hit the Apply or Finalize button to save your port forwarding rule. Next, you will want to make sure that the IP address you made the rule for is always tied to the device you want to access. To do this, you are going to tell the router to keep the same IP address for that device no matter what. This will ensure that if the router is turned off or is updated, that the port forwarding rules will still work and still take you to the device you desire. You will be able to configure the static IP address under the LAN settings of your device. From here, we will click the Add button to create a new rule, and then choose the device and the IP address we want to remain static. As you can see, when we go to give our IP camera a static IP address, it has already changed with an IP address ending in .27. We are going to change the IP address to end in .10 to match the port forwarding rule we created. We will now finalize this rule by clicking the Add button at the top of the screen. Now we know the port forwarding rule will continue to work and will take you to the correct device on your network. Once the rules have been saved, you will want to make sure that the port forwarding is working, and the easiest way to do that is to go to portchecktool.com. Once there, the site will automatically find your current public IP address and then give you the option to add the port number you would like to test. Since we created the rule for 8000, we will check that port with the tool. If you get this green success message, that means you have successfully configured port forwarding in your router and were able to access your device remotely. The port check tool can also throw some errors, meaning that it was not able to successfully connect to your device. The most common reason for failure would be connection timed out. This error usually occurs when the port forwarding rules aren't set properly, or if there's an external device or service that is blocking your connection. After double-checking your port forwarding settings, it's a good idea to contact your ISP or internet service provider to make sure that they are not blocking any ports or to check any firewalls that you may have configured at the network. The other common error you will run into is connection refused. This usually means that the port forwarding rules are set up properly and we were able to talk to your network. However, the device itself is not letting the connection be established. You will want to double-check the remote connection settings for your device and make sure that the inbound port is configured to the same port you have set up for port forwarding. If you are having issues fixing this error, it is a good idea to contact the device manufacturer to make sure it is correctly configured for remote connection. Thank you for watching this NoIP support video. Please like and subscribe to see all future content, and if you have an idea for a video, please leave it in the comments below.